So our next guest is Carole Wacey, CEO of the Women's City Club of New York, or WCC, whose membership will also be participating in today's Women's March to stand up against intolerance and hate and to stand up for equal rights and equal protections. Good morning, Carole.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Sure. Yeah. Carole, this is Bika. What is the Women's City Club of New York and what are your goals?
So the Women's City Club is a nonprofit, nonpartisan, multi-issue advocacy organization. That's a mouthful. It's an organization that's been around since 1915, founded by trailblazers like Eleanor Roosevelt and Frances Perkins, really to address, at that time, they were looking at sort of the general right to vote, the 19th Amendment. And now we're fighting for things like getting people out to vote and make sure our voices are heard. So we have a lot of goals. Our goal mostly is to really think about how we, as mostly women, but not all women, we have male members as well, can address important progressive issues, but as I say, we're nonpartisan, that affect and improve the lives of all New Yorkers. So that's broadly what we're focused on.
The organization is more than hi, this is Edwina, and thank you for coming on our show today, because I'm sure you're incredibly busy. So WCC is more than 100 years old. What do you think has contributed to its ability to sustain itself for such a long time? What do you think its most important building blocks are at keeping it moving forward and remaining current?
I think what has been great is, you know, just historically, if you look at women in society, women are always, they always care about things that are affecting their lives, the lives of their families, the lives of their community. So it's very natural that women would take on leadership roles. Going back, this was back in the early 1900s, and today it's no different. I think our bigger challenge today is we have a lot of working women. So finding time where women who work maybe have children and families to take care of, are finding time to do this work. I'll tell you, I've been with the Women's City Club just since November.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. I've been in the nonprofit world, media, public media, as well as running youth development nonprofits and government, and I feel very privileged to be working with this organization that's been around for such a long time and really has, from the early days, laid out an important agenda with leaders from all walks of life coming together to really think about those issues that are important to our city, where we can have an impact, where we actually do take action, and we make New York City better for all people. And if we look back to the early days, it was things like there was a birthing center that the Women's City Club was involved with at a time when not everyone was looking at the health of mothers and children, which continues to be an issue today. It's certainly been in the media as well. You look at even somebody like Serena Williams had those challenges today, and you wouldn't expect that from somebody like her, but those are big issues, and our governor just laid out an agenda, you know, really also addressing those issues, to today where the Women's City Club is working on all kinds of issues like phys ed for all. You'd think physical education for kids in the school would be just sort of part of their overall education. That's not always the case. So the mayor here in New York City has been working on that, and we've been a part of a coalition to work on that. So you can kind of start to see the broad spectrum of issues that the city club's worked on over the years.
So as you know, today is the Women's March in New York City, in D.C., and across the country and globe, again, to commemorate the second year. Tell us about WCC's participation. What are the reasons you and your members are participating in the march?
Yeah, and it was really exciting. I live in Queens. I took the train in this morning. I came in quite early, what I thought was quite early. I thought the trains would be quiet, and they weren't. They were jam-packed, and people had signs, and it's men and women and all ages and people coming together who don't know each other. So it's really exciting to sort of see that energy. And not surprisingly, the Women's City Club was involved a year ago with the march. We're back here again, and I've already been getting texts from people who are out on the street waiting for us, and our team is all gathering up on 74th and Amsterdam right now. If people want to come out, we'll be there Well, people are there now, and we're officially gathering around 11 o'clock. And what we're really hoping for this year is the theme of the march is March into Action. So last year, everyone sort of came together coming out of the election and feeling somewhat challenged, and now we've gone a year later. There are bigger challenges and different challenges, and the idea is let's all come together and really take a step forward, stand shoulder to shoulder with your neighbor, with people you don't know, with people you do know, and really determine what we can do to make a difference. And a big part of that, and you see that in a lot of the messaging around the marches, is about voting. I mentioned earlier how the Women's City Club was involved in the 19th Amendment and getting women the right to vote. Now we got to make sure not only women, but everybody gets out and votes and makes sure their voice is heard. And we know how important that is, and we see it even with what's happening in Washington right now with the government shutting down. We want to make sure people are, you know, making sure they're electing the people that will represent their values and the policies that are important to make the lives better for all people.
So this is Edwina again. Do you have a specific platform that you're connecting with your participation in the march this year?
Well, we have a very broad platform. As I said, we're nonpartisan, but our real goal is about civic engagement. How do we give everybody, regardless of their background, we happen to be called the Women's City Club, but this is not an elite club for the few. This is a club that everybody is welcome to be a part of, men and women, young and old, rich and not rich. We want people who really care about the community to come to us and say, you know, these are the issues that are important to us. We've worked on a wide variety of issues over the years. We work on everything from education to good government to healthcare to the environment. Our list is broad, but we always try to find that intersection between what does our city need, where can our membership be helpful, and how can we best take action to positively influence whatever issue we're working on for New Yorkers.
So this year's march, it's expected that there will be many, many people marching. Actually, I was looking at the New York City Facebook page before the show, and I can't remember. It was like, 40-something thousand said they were going, and then 70-something thousand said they were interested. And I showed that to Jonathan, and he said, yeah, that was what it was last year. And there were like a million people on the streets, So it's like, and I was like, oh yeah, you're right. I just kind of forgot about it, 'cause I was in the DC march, and the same thing happened there where it was just a flood. But, there have been some articles recently on this, building up to the 1 year anniversary, that talked about concerns of burnout or concerns that level of resistance and activism can't be it will be hard to maintain it in years 2, 3, and 4. And, if it was 8 years even. Mm. And that, but that there have been, things like the Me Too movement that has kept these very important women's and social justice issues on the forefront of the people's minds in the news every day, that also keeps that activism going. So what are your thoughts on that issue?
Yeah, so first about burnout, and I heard this a lot from people coming out of last year, that people were very jazzed up. They were very excited coming out of it. They did and took lots of action sort of coming out of it. And then they sort of, like you say, they fizzled out. They didn't know what to do. And I think that's really the responsibility of organizations like the Women's City Club to find, and there's many organizations like us out there that are working in a variety of issues to really support the engagement of our citizens. And, I'd ask people to take a look at our website. It's wccny.org. Look at the issues we're working on. Tell us what you care about. We really want to hear from people across the city, and we really want to give a vehicle for people to get involved. For example, I was at an event about a week ago. The governor issued his report on the status of women and girls in New York. He laid out a very, very ambitious and exciting agenda which spans health, safety, the workplace, girls, family. And within each of those, there's an opportunity to get involved. I'll tell you, we're going to be working. Our plan is to work really closely with the governor's office. I spoke with them yesterday about how we can support some of that work. So our goal is to make sure we have a very active, engaged opportunity for, you know, anyone who wants to get involved with this work to really join us. And we have to find those vehicles to do that for everyone so that there really are great actions people can take. And the underlying message, too, is, you know, it does make a difference if you vote. It does make a difference if you do get engaged with your community. And we're here in New York City. We have so many great elected officials here that are doing really amazing work and are very open to hearing from their constituents and giving them an opportunity to get involved. So my hope is that people will do that. And my hope is, as you were talking about the numbers, we know about 100,000 people registered to come out today, and we're expecting a lot more. And we're very lucky the sun is shining down on us today with this great weather, certainly here in New York and along the East Coast. So we hope to have a really strong turnout. And then coming out of this, people are very energized to really help us take that action we're expecting with our march into action today.
You're listening to Carole Wacey of the Women's City Club of New York with Bickhoff Pham, Edwina Francis Martin on City Watch, WBAI New York, 99.5 FM, and streaming live at WBAI.org.
Hey, Carole, this is Edwina. You had mentioned earlier the importance of getting people to vote. And we know what a difference it made in the special election in Alabama a few weeks ago. And we just went through in November here in New York City and other cities and towns around New York State municipal elections. And in New York City, we had, once again, record low turnout. Even though there were a number of open seats on the city council, for example. So what sort of, are you doing any sort of voter and voting related activities today? And what kind of activities do you have planned for after? Like, for example, are you doing any voter registration or anything like that? Or do you think it's just going to be too crazy to try to do that?
Yeah, I don't know. I imagine, and I'm not aware specifically of voter registration taking place today. I imagine there's a lot of that. It's all about power to the polls and getting people out to vote. But certainly the Women's City Club, given our early history around the right to vote and the knowledge of how important it is to get high numbers out to the polls, because as we saw in Alabama and we've seen in communities all across America during these local elections, and certainly also with our national elections, it's really important. It is that message that every vote does count. I think we still have somewhat of an education process. I think, you know, even looking at some of the legislation about early voting and making it as easy as possible, there's no reason that people shouldn't be able to vote at a time that is convenient for them. We want to get away from some of those policies that just really prevent so many people from being able to vote. So those are things that we will continue to work on that we really see as important. So part of it is to make it as easy as possible, and part of it is to educate everyone to understand that when we have the right to vote, we really owe it to everyone to take advantage of that right, to make our voice be heard, whatever side of the aisle we're on. But we've got to get those numbers up much higher than they are. It's not reflecting all that, you know, people are thinking across America, and we really need to do that.
Yeah, I grew up in Washington State, and years ago, when my parents still live there, and years ago, they went to a mail-in ballot option, and I think that's the primary way people vote. I think Oregon has done the same thing, and they have seen a large increase in the number of people, eligible voters, voting, particularly amongst people of color and lower income people. And to me, you know, with you mentioned earlier, with so many women today who are working full time, may have children or other demands on their time, we're all running around like crazy, you know, trying to just get the groceries done, you know, shopping, and it just makes sense to me to give people the option to do a mail-in vote ballots. Many states have done them. They have had very good anti-fraud measures and are equally strong in those security procedures as you know other states that don't. I believe he was the director of the New York State Elections Board, who said that he had some concerns about voting by mail because of fraud issues. And I thought, like, you know, can you look at these other states? I mean, like, let's go based upon facts and current facts and, you know, talk to their state board of elections and see how is it they can pull it off. I feel like we're in such bad shape in terms of the percentage of people voting, like Edwina brought up, that we're kind of in desperate times. You know, we need to try some voter friendly ways to get people to exercise their vote.
100%. Everything you said is exactly right. There's no reason that we wouldn't want to make it as easy as possible to let all of our citizens vote. That says a lot to me that we don't do that right now, especially given all the parameters. And we know who that unfairly disadvantages. There are people that just don't have the flexibility in their schedule to get out during voting hours, even if they are technically extended beyond the formal business day. That still can be very challenging for some. So I think that's an area where we can, and certainly we at the Women's City Club can spend some of our energy, and we'd love to have people work with us and help us think about the best ways to do that. And there are a lot of great organizations working on this. And ultimately, you know, we also want to make sure people understand that if they do vote, their voices will be heard. And in a time when there are such big challenges, we want everyone to be part of government. We have the good fortune to have a democracy. And we just want to make sure everyone can really effectively participate in that. And I think that's a good goal for all of us to have.
What are you hearing from your folks out at the march right now? Are they screaming for you to come down?
I know. Well, that's what I'm hearing. Well, we told everyone we would be there by 11. So we know that there's a crowd gathering. And I said, you know, I was coming in at 8:30 this morning, and it was so fun to see so many people out with signs and excited, and everyone's cheering everybody else on. I have my pink pants on, and somebody's bringing me my nice pink pussy hat. So I'm so excited. It will be, and we have signs, and, you know, we want people to just come out and be excited. And I think the energy was already out there this morning at 8 o'clock. I can only imagine it's getting better. The sun is shining. And the number of handmade signs I saw people bringing in, you know.
What are some of the best signs that you've seen?
Well, there's a lot about not being silenced. You know, I don't remember any of the specifics yet, but I'm happy. I'll be happy. I'll be taking pictures. We'll be posting on our social media, on our Instagram accounts for the Women's City Club. And I'm just excited to see all these people come out and get together and stand together on something that's so important. And marching, it has such a great history in this country. My hope is that with everyone coming together, we're learning from each other, we're listening to each other. I want everyone to see, you know, everyone has a mom, you know, many people have sisters, and, you know, we're all in this together. We want this country to do well, to really progress in very positive ways. And I think this march is just really emblematic of that. I'm excited to be a part of it. I'm excited to be running the Women's City Club. I'm excited to meet new people and think about things that we should be working on and hopefully lay out an exciting agenda and really make a difference and just continue. New York City is a great place. I feel very privileged to live and work here, to raise two little boys here, to be a part of this amazing community. And we just deserve better. We just want to keep making things better and better. We've made great progress since, you know, 1915 when my organization was started, but we still have a long way to go. And I'm just excited to see people coming together to really try to make a difference. I think it's very exciting. I'm feeling very optimistic and so excited to be here today and so appreciative to have for you to invite me onto your show as well.
Well, Carole, we appreciate you coming in so early to make this call interview happen. Thank you for all your work and your lifetime of advocacy on so many different issues, and see you at the march.
Oh, can you just share how to find you one more time, social media, website?
Great. Thanks for that. So the Women's City Club, we are at wccny.org is our website. You can come to Facebook, which is Women City Club NY. Our Twitter is at Women City Club NY, and our LinkedIn is also Women City Club NY. You can also find us on Instagram, and I'm going to be heading up to meet my crew at 74th and Amsterdam. You'll see us with the Women City Club signs, and we'd love to have you join us. If you're alone, if you're with a crowd, come join us. We'll be marching. We'll be proud. We'll be positive. And we're just excited to have as many people join us as are around. We're excited.
See you at the march.
Yes.
All right. Thank you both so much. Really appreciate the time.
Sure.